Hold on, this is the Rules Committee meeting for July 18th, 2014. Roll call.
Jennifer Johnston.
Dick Training.
Toby Green Johnson.
Darrell Hess.
Okay. Let's say approval of the agenda.
So approved.
There's agenda. Motion approves, any objection? Not seeing any, we move the minutes of previous meetings, there are none. Old business or incident, new business. 6A is acceptance of community council bylaws filed in conforming university in Spinard. Darrell, you went through both of them?
Yes, I worked with the council presidents for both of these councils. We exchanged multiple emails, I think one of them up to 10 emails, you know, passing the draft bylaws back and forth and as they work to come into conformity with the code.
So as far as you're concerned, these do conform?
In my opinion, they conform to the code as amended by the assembly on February 11th of this year.
So, Mr. Chairman, if I may,
yes,
move to accept the community council bylaws followed by university and Spinard community councils.
Second.
Moved and seconded, any objection? Seeing none, those are done. And now we'll just send them on to the assembly. And then we're down to item 6B, which is information regarding community council bylaws filed and non-conforming Bear Valley Community Council. Mr. Hess, sir, can you tell us about this one?
The chairman, Mr. Trainee, asked me to bring to the meeting, you know, the copy of the email. This is the copy of the email that I actually sent to the clerk's office and to the chair of the Bear Valley Community Council. And it's an example of some of the situations I've been running into reviewing bylaws. Bear Valley, there was no reference to an executive board in the bylaws, and that is mandated in the ordinance. There was no reference to Robert's Rules of Order. Once again, that's mandated by the ordinance. They referenced property owners in the bylaws versus non-resident property owners, which is, I think, when they talk about the definition of the councils, you can list property owners. But when you talk about membership requirements, you have to say non-resident property owners because that is how they're referenced in the code. They talked about dues being voluntary, but there was language that said are to be paid at the October meeting. So, you know, I suggested they might change that. It was especially confusing because they had no reference to the fact, as required by the code, that membership and participation in voting cannot be predicated upon payment of any monetary sum, and that is mandated to be in the bylaws. In the bylaws, they talked about nonprofits and businesses and property owners having one vote, which may be especially confusing. Everybody has one vote, but the revised code says that non-resident property owners, businesses, corporations, nonprofits shall have a designated representative and may have an alternate. So, you know, it really needs to be in the bylaws or it might lead to some confusion down the road. They had a requirement in their bylaws for a minimum of 4 general membership meetings a year. However, they didn't reference the requirement in the revised code that they must meet at least once per calendar quarter. It's interesting, they talked about attendance at 6 meetings prior to the vote. They really need to talk about attendance requirements for a number of months, not meetings, because in the code it references months rather than meetings. And they actually had a requirement for prior meeting attendance for voting on bylaws. And the ordinance says you can have prior meeting attendance requirement and not have one meeting in the previous 12 months to vote on any issue, or not more than prior meeting attendance and not more than 2 meetings to vote for election of officers. And other than that, bylaw shall not otherwise restrict eligibility to vote by members in attendance. So they cannot have a requirement for prior meeting attendance to vote on bylaws, other than the requirement that you have attended a meeting once in the previous 12 months. Then that would apply to any vote of the council. So it's kind of an example of some of the things we've been seeing
with
the draft bylaws.
Who's president of Bear Valley now?
I think it was Sherry.
So Sherry's still there?
Sherry.
She's not as active as it used to be.
No. We had actually passed some emails back and forth that I know Mr. Trainee was copied on an email. She said, well, I submitted these to you earlier. Why didn't you make these comments? And I actually pulled up the old email, and I did miss the first two items when we originally talked, but the others I had all, I had added corrections in blue, and they somehow fell out. You know, they're volunteers. You know, we passed back multiple drafts. You probably misplaced that draft or something.
No,
that's why we're not, you know, we're giving them plenty of time to do it.
Could you send another email to her saying, hey, we have, these are the problems we have. I mean, if you sent it before, send it to her.
I sent this to her.
You did send it.
And I forwarded her the old email that I had sent because I saved
it. Has she responded that she got it, understands it?
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, no, she used to send out notices and everything. And so I think she maybe is one of those cases where she...
She did acknowledge receiving this email, but not the when I forwarded her the previous one. So she did get this email with the non-conformities.
No,
she said they're going to work on it.
Yeah, you got my support.
Okay. Okay. Let's take on that. Now we get down to C, 6C. We have information regarding community council requests and granted an extension. With Putna Valley Community Council, Mountain View Community Council, Turning In Community Council, Mid Hillside Community Council, and I would like to add number 5, Campbell Park Community Council. I attended a meeting last night, and they're not able to get it done right now, but by the next deadline they'll
And
have
can
it.
We add Bear Valley?
I think so.
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Chairman?
Yes?
At the previous committee meeting, the committee, I think, made the decision that anybody who can submits non-conforming bylaws, they're automatically granted an extension because they just submit them.
But you guys have a problem adding Campbell Park? Mm-hmm. And I promise my wife will have it done by the next meeting. She was given the task last night to rewrite them.
These are the councils that had submitted requests since your last meeting, so I asked you to put them on here as information.
So we get a motion to approve these 5. A second.
Mr. Chairman, move to approve these 5 extensions.
Okay.
Second.
Second.
You don't want to add Campbell Creek?
No. I want to add Campbell Creek. There was 5. There's 4 lists. I added Campbell
Park.
Campbell Park.
Campbell Park.
So we've got 5 on there now. Any objection? Seeing none, that's approved. Members' comments. Ma'am. Sarah, you got your bike here? Going to ride home?
Right. Amanda has a comment.
Amanda. For clarification through the chair, the clerk's office will at this point prepare the AIM.
Right.
And just to be sure, we want to include the information on the acceptance for university area in Spinard. And you would also like to have on the AIM the information
extension granted
for
to
Bear
those.
Valley and then the other 5.
Not on the Bear Valley one. That one we can just leave silent for now.
But did you want to mention that they, because they had submitted non-conforming bylaws, they're automatically granted?
Automatically granted extension. That's what they can do.
So I'll have that they've been granted an extension, and you would also like to have Clutha Valley, Mountain View, Turnagain, Mid Hillside, and Campbell Park.
Campbell Park and Mid Hillside.
Okay. The clerk's office will then prepare that.
Thank you,
ma'am. Tina, let's see if you will help.
Anything from the audience? Kathy?
Yes, Kathy Gleason. Well, I wanted to come here because I'm curious what your process is to approve bylaws that have been submitted by councils. Turnagain had submitted an extension, and we've had some conflict within our board, with our president, as far as our process. We've been asking for months some kind of work product from the 3-person committee that Bill Wortman appointed, and it has yet to be provided to the board or any members of the Turnagain Community Council. And unilaterally, our president scheduled 2 special meetings to hand out these bylaws. They're not being distributed electronically via email through FCC or posted on our website. The board voted yesterday to oppose the special meeting scheduled for July 24th because there's just not been a good public process from the board's perspective on how we're doing things. So any advice that you can provide our council would be helpful. At this point in time, based on board discussion, there is no way we're going to approve these at our September meeting. They're giving the president's giving the council members 1 week to submit comments. If you can show up at the July 24th meeting to get a hard copy, you've got 1 week to review and get your comments back to the committee. And that's just not a good process. And so I would encourage this body, depending on continued feedback you get from the Turnagain Community Council Board, to not approve anything Turnagain submits. It clearly is going to need more time in the fall for a broader review period for those of us who have shown a lot of interest but haven't been given the ability to review them at all yet. So it's unfortunate this has played out the way it has, but I want to keep this body informed about what's going on. The distribution just isn't there. We cannot get our hands on anything right now.
Ms. Johnson?
I would suggest that Mr. Hess maybe get in touch with the president and spend some time to sort of with his concerns, and so you can at some point give us a report as far as where you see the process.
I've spoken with the president. Actually, he's come in and met with me several times regarding the bylaws, and I've had multiple council members call me regarding the bylaws. Before the bylaws are submitted to the clerk's office and before they're forwarded to me for review, they have to be approved by the membership. So it's not going to, we're not going to review bylaws, and the assembly's not going to, you know, accept bylaws that haven't been approved by the membership.
Eric, could you call the president from the council and see if there's anything we can give to him?
Sure.
If you would, please.
He's out of town right now and not answering his cell. So just to give you a heads up, I wouldn't even try today. I think he's going to be back in town Tuesday.
He's been into my office at least 4 or 5 times to talk about it.
So you've got a relationship with him?
Yeah. I think the problem is he hasn't communicated at all with the board with regard to any of this. And that's really keeping us in the dark, which is really unfortunate. And so I'm glad he's communicating with you, but we don't have any idea what your communications with him have been. We have no idea. And what you've talked about. So it's just an unfortunate process that I hope at some point we can get turned around so that we can move forward. I don't anticipate being able to approve our bylaws by September.
Okay, we need that.
Chairman, my understanding is that when the committee submitted their last report to the assembly, that the deadline was extended to November 31st.
Yeah.
So perhaps I should
wait a little bit of time yet.
I will send an email to the Federation and request that they send it out to the council.
Sorry,
as a reminder.
Mark's got it for a couple of weeks.
Okay.
So, I'm sorry, what was that?
The deadline's been extended to November 30th.
For councils to submit bylaws?
Right.
Didn't know that. Okay, well, that gives us some good breathing room then.
Well, part of the problem was summer meetings and vacation.
Yeah, that's been a huge
problem. The committee didn't want to make it overly burdensome on the council.
Yeah,
okay, we're at the end of our agenda. Motion to adjourn.
Move to adjourn. Second.
We're adjourned.